I guess I'm clearing my throat to the microphone. Are you still there, kiddo? Listen, I've got everything under control. No. What? Oh, brother. You and Gart, right? A little trouble under the sheets? Say no more. Papa's got this. Big Papa. Redrick says, God, what is happening in your head? Oh, God. The static appears to breathe heavily. Please just stay out of it. I have no choice, really. Other than to say this, I've got a hunch your love life is about to take a very pleasant turn. Give the lieutenant a knowing wink. What? Kim says. Lieutenant rises his shoulders. What is it? You'll see, Lieutenant. You will see. Wink again. New task. Talk to Gart, Lieutenant Love. Call was terminated by the other party. Anything else, officer? It's on, Empathy says. The love quest is on. Too late, everyone. It's on. Take it to Gart now. No, I'll leave the poor girl alone. Could you connect me to the 41st precinct? I have something I need to report. Just a second, officer. She puts you on hold, the static crackling softly, like a bonfire. After a while, you hear an old man greet you from the radio. His rattly voice is oddly familiar. 10-2, 10-5. This is the 41st. Come in. Over. Jules Pidou. A scrawny old man sits in a dusty cubicle smoking, with a large white rectangle sewn on his vest. In front of him is a box-shaped apparatus with an array of wires and antennas, the radio switchboard. This man uses relay code, Encyclopedia says. You got this, you're a cop, and cops know relay code. 10-4, Station 41, I've got an urgent business, over. 10-4. Message received. 10-5, relay message. What's your status? Over. Just reporting in. Over. 10-18, state your message, sir. I need to report my badge missing. The lieutenant eyes go wide. But you said... He shakes his head. Never mind. Yeah, I know, Kim. 10-9, over. My badge, I can't find it anywhere. Basically, it's gone. 10-4, message received. This is a very serious situation. I need you to 10-22, the captain. Over. Is this the captain? Jean's Vicmaire? Is it him? A dry voice asks in the background. What does he want? Says he lost his badge and needs to report it. He... What? He lost his badge? Hey, who is this? This is Communications Officer Jules Pidou, sir. Over. No, the other one. You mean your partner? Over. What is he saying? Jean says. He's asking who you are. I'm his goddamn partner. Oh, he's my regular partner. Not like him. It's your partner, Satellite Officer Vicmaire, sir. It's your partner, Satellite Officer Vicmaire, sir. Over. Did he lose his memory along with his badge? The man in the background sounds like he's losing his patience. Chester. Who's Chester? Chester McLean says, who lost his badge? Dick Mullen. Who do you think? It's Officer Dick. He tries to speak through laughter. Mullen from the bestseller Dick Mullen and the Lost Identity. Encyclopedia says, Dick Mullen is not your name. It is the name of a fictional detective who would not lose his badge. Authority says, defend yourself. Immediately. They're laughing at you. Okay. Defending myself. Is this defending myself too? I guess so. This is like more offended. I don't know. Ha ha. Officer lost his badge. Ha ha. Like I'm the first cop to ever misplace his badge. Jules says, he says this has probably happened to other policemen before him, and laughs sarcastically. Jean says, oh god damn it, is he kidding? The whole station's gonna be dicked for this. Satellite Officer Vicmaire is wondering if you might be joking and adds that this tarnishes the reputation of the entire station. Over. I like that he's translating this into, like, more diplomatic speech. Chester says, Mullen dicked us. Come on, operator, tell them to stop. This is serious. He's asking you to stop, says this is serious. Of course it's serious. He lost his badge. Satellite Officer Vic Mayer concurs. Losing your badge is serious. Over. Brother. Can't we just move on? I want to get it reported and be done with. Task complete. Report your badge missing. 30 XP. Oh, he leveled up. New task. Track down your badge. Jewel says, 10-4, I hear you, officer. I'm just going to make a note here that you're in pursuit of your misplaced badge. Over. Cheshire says, screw me. Mac, come here. You've got to hear this. Dick Mullen lost his badge. Mac Torreson says, what's going on? Supercop here lost his badge. He lost his what now? His badge, Zahn says. He lost his goddamn badge. Could you all please stop saying lost his badge for a moment? Jules says, he asked you to please stop saying he lost his badge. Max says, why? Did he find it? The room at the other end of the line erupts in volcanic laughter. Sergeant Torreson was wondering if you found your badge yet. Over. Reaction speed failure. You don't have a comeback, sorry. It's hard to think like this. Say nothing. He's not replying. Looks like he is still looking for it. You can hear laughter in the background. Enough with this now. I have other things to discuss. 10-9, come again. I didn't get that. Over. The animated conversation in the back is making it difficult for him to hear you. Chester says, new heights, even for Captain Sober. Max says, ask him. The speaker gasped for air. Ask him if he lost his gun, too. The room roars with laughter. Sergeant Torreson wants to know if you lost your gun, too. Over. This guy, Jules, is the perfect straight man. Check your pockets. Check your... You didn't know where... You don't know where it is, do you? Oh, God, it's not here. Half-light. Yeah, okay, it's gone. Your gun is most likely gone. 10-9, come in, officer. Did you get my question? We were wondering about your gun. Over. High chance of this. Let's convince... Try to convince them that you didn't lose your gun. Success. Lying over the phone? It's easy. Just say it like it's the truth, and then it becomes it. Close. It's a radio. No, of course I didn't lose my gun. He says he didn't. Jean says, thank God for that. That would have been a nightmare. I don't even want to imagine the poor prick who has to relay that kind of news to the captain. Losing his badge is bad enough. Tell him to find it, and fast. We can't have some gangbanger running around with it. New task, track down your gun. Jules says, we're all glad to hear you've not lost your gun, officer. Do you need further assistance? Over. I am in dire need of financial assistance. 10-4, I hear you. I don't have the authority to grant your request, but... Jean says, what does he want now? He is asking for money. Is he kidding? I don't think he is. Don't give that asshole anything. He's just gonna drink it all. Task updated. Pay for damages. Okay. Jules says, all right. The operator turns back to you. That's a negative on the additional fund, sir. Over. Please, I'm begging you here. I don't even have a place to sleep tonight. He says he's in trouble. Doesn't have a place to sleep. Well, I guess he better crack the case before sundown, then. Vic Mara said, ugh. It is paramount to the investigation that you grant me more money. He says it's important to the case. Jean says he isn't getting a red cent. You can tell him that. Request denied, sir. Over. I don't want to be here anymore. I want to go home. Please come and get me. Listen. He seems to lower his voice a bit, carefully choosing his words. It's okay. You can do it, sir. Over. Jean says, what is he saying? The operator chooses to ignore the voice in the background. Did you want anything else, sir? He asks you. Many of your colleagues are also here. Over. He's trying to keep you from further embarrassing yourself in front of your colleagues. No, I'm all right. I'm all right. I had other things. Let us address them now, sir. Over. This might sound odd, but there's personal details I'd like to discuss. Okay, 10-4, sir. I hear you. Relay your question, over. Rhetoric says, wait, before you say anything stupid, think it through. What's there to think about? You're going to be looking at a straitjacket if you tell everyone you lost your memory. Be smart about this. Ask if he's there alone. 10-4, sir, I'm not hearing your question. The radio operator inquires again. You just said people were in the room. Unless they just walked out. Any news about my, family? Excuse me, sir? Over? You probably don't want to continue on this road. Okay. Nothing, never mind. Have I ever told you about my life before the RCM? 10-4, well that's a... Jean says, he actually wants something, or is he hell-bent on disrupting our work? He asked if he ever told me about his days before joining the RCM. For God's sakes, cut this out. Tell him to stop wasting time and be a goddamn policeman for a change. Sir, Satellite Officer Vic Mara says, I heard him. So is there anything else? Hold on, are you alone in the room? I need some confidential information about myself. That's a negative, sir. I got a 10-12 visitors present here, over. Alright, yeah, let's wrap this up. 10-10, over. Roger that, 10-10, over and out. The static ends with a loud click, then everything is silent in the cabin. Close the door. Well, alright, we got stuff. We got a bunch of tools. Check them out. Pry bar. Equip this to open locked containers in the world. The red-tipped pry bar has Carson T heavy-duty engraved just below the handle. It is satisfyingly heavy and perhaps one of the most useful tools to carry around. Chain cutters. The meanest-looking pair of cutters you have ever seen, made in Gottwald by Walsham Worksage. I don't know. No chain, wire, nor barbed fence will ever stand in your way again. They look hungry, ready to chew steel. A police flashlight bearing the logo of Grunstelling RAO. The small dynamo packed inside this handheld illumination device theoretically gives you the ability to produce a tiny amount of electricity anytime, anywhere. Alright. I got a thought cabinet thing? Okay. 4 hours, 52 remaining. We got a lot of quests. Pay for damages. Okay. We crossed that out. That didn't work. Ask station for additional funds. Talk to Gart, Lieutenant Love. Gart plus Sylvie equals question mark. Something's going on here. You need to help a brother out with his love woes. Go to Gart and give him some solid advice. Tell him how it is with women. This is, like, not going to work. I have a quest which I know is just... idiotic. But I'm gonna see where it goes. Track down your badge. It is unclear how you should go about finding a tiny piece of plastic in a world as large as this. Perhaps you just stumble across it down the line. Miracles happen. Track down your gun. Someone must know something about your lost firearm. Maybe a district authority. Like someone high up in the union, or someone local who saw you with it before you passed out. The whirling's absent bartender. You could also ask the local pawn shop. Find any information you can on the gun. I could call her back. We don't want to, though. Okay, level up. What happened? Okay, so our rhetoric went up. Did anything else go up? 5, 6, 5, 6, 5. So rhetoric is our chosen skill. I guess only that levels up. Learn skill plus one, signature skill plus one. Okay. We have so leveled up. Can I talk to him about my badge or anything? Alright, let's go try to find this body. Finally. I guess it's through there, the hole. So look at this, whatever this is. There are bottles inside. You could pick them up if you had a bag. Guess I don't have a bag. Someone over there, but let's look at this. Rue de Saint Ghislaine 8B. Electronic doorbell. An old call box with a matrix of push buttons lists all the companies in the East Delta Commerce Center. Really? All this stuff? Main hall, building A? An off-key melody starts playing after you ring the doorbell. Then a woman picks up the receiver. Cuno! Please stop calling here. Grown-ups won't have time for your stupid games. Who's Cuno? This is the police. Please open the door. Oh, I'm sorry, officer. I thought you were... There's a spot of static that overrides her words. But the doorbell is broken and the bookstore shouldn't even be on the list anymore, so I can't help you. Please don't call here again. Thanks. A single beep indicates that the line has gone dead. You hear the same waiting room music, but no one picks up the receiver anymore. Andrew Orlando Hare SCA. You ring the doorbell, but no one answers. Conceptualization says, what an ominous name for a hair salon. Doesn't bode well for anyone's hair. Andrew Orlando. Are Timoteps boxing for young athletes in gym? All you hear is static, but no one answers the call. 24-hour window? You ring the doorbell, but nothing happens. Emma's Fashion Atelier? You wait for a moment, minute or two, but all you get from the call box is silence. No one answers the call. Fabron's Taxi? The rest has been burned off. Looks like someone has melted half the plastic off with a lighter. The doorbell doesn't work anymore. Slipstream SCA. You hear static from the intercom speaker. It sounds as if someone has picked up the receiver, but isn't saying anything. Hello? Is anyone there? Yes. Hello, this is Tricentennial Electrics. This is a woman's voice, crackling and fragile through the static. Have you come to place an order? She sounds almost antique, as if her voice was being played off an old wax cylinder. Her receiver must not be working properly. Hold on, Tricentennial Electrics? I thought I was calling Slipstream SCA. My God. The lieutenant exchanges a look with you. Sorry? It's you. My God, I didn't think I would hear your voice again. Who cares that you don't remember her, Drama says. Just go along with it. Inland Empire says, no, something's wrong here. Are you sure she's talking to you? Do we know each other? Michelle, just please... She stops, and you can hear her breathe heavily, her breath distorted by ancient static. Why did you even call? I don't understand. You've been gone for months. She sounds like she's shaking. I thought you didn't care. Hold on. Tell me what's going on. What did I do? Ever since I came to work here, it's been different, as if my mind's been wiped clean. A spot of static overrides her words. When she speaks again, it sounds like she's submerged. It's so nice. It's so nice to be able to finally forget. Forget about what? She sounds like she's about to cry. Hello? She doesn't answer. You said it was nice. What's so nice about forgetting? Silence. The only thing you can hear now is static and waves washing ashore on the bay. What just happened? Another seagull passes by. It's getting cold standing here, staring at the silent coal box. Kim says, I don't know what happened either. The lieutenant inspects the doorbell. We should probably stop playing with this thing. All right, it's a goodbye then. You press the number sign on the keypad that terminates the call. 12 name cards on the call box read. Slipstream SCA. Failure. No, hold on. The last thing you need in your life is more hysteric emotions. Forget it. Find something else to do. Okay, Fortress Accident SCA. Silence. No one's home at Fortress Accident. Revachol Ice City. Silence. No one answers the doorbell. Main Hall Building B, whirling in rags. Nothing happens after you ring the doorbell. They don't seem to want to talk to you. East Delta Pinball. Entrance from Building B. Silence. No one answers your call. Empty card. This button looks new, but someone has removed the name card. Nothing happens when you try to ring it. Kim says, this button looks new. It's probably not connected yet. He takes a step back, inspecting the other names on the list. Does he have something to say?
Yes.
All right. I want to look at this body already. Maybe we can go in there, but let's look at the body. It's right through here, should be. Is it? I thought it was. Well, there it is. Yeah, Cuno, screw him up. Kid.
Cuno's got this!
The boy throwing rocks at the dead body can't be older than 12. If there was ever such a thing as an ugly kid, then this is it. He's almost exquisite in his ugliness, like a gremlin.
Oh yeah, never could be Cuno.
Cuno S? Yells the other kid behind the fence. Hey kid, a word? Police business.
Right in the dick, Cuno! Get him right in the dick!
The children ignore you.
Love it in the dick!
Okay. The boy is sweating profusely. His eyes are like two black holes, and his jaw is twitching as if trying to break free from the empire of his body. Stop throwing rocks at my crime scene.
Fuck that Cuno! Yeah, right in the mouth hole!
The shit himself!
The rake, Cuno!
The rake?
You should throw the rake at him, Cuno!
The fuck does Cuno know what a rake is? Cuno's not a gardener!
Look, I have questions for you.
Entertain the Cuno! Show me what you got! What you got there? What you got, huh? Show me what you got!
He's jutting his chin out. Logic says irregular speech patterns, overconfidence. Could this kid be on drugs? This warrants further investigation into this Cuno. I gotta ask, who is Cuno? Cuno's Cuno, pig! The boy points to his chest with both thumbs. It's always Cuno, never I. Clearly the kid's using the third-person perspective as a shield. Interesting. You refer to yourself in the third person to distance yourself from the situation? Cuno doesn't do the smart shit. He seems offended. Don't throw that book shit at Cuno. Cuno knows you're lying. Trying to get Cuno hooked on the book. Watch out, Cuno. He's trying to fiddle you. He's going to put his hands on you. The thing behind the fence starts squealing, shrill and violent like a fire alarm. The sound gets louder as the child shouts at the windows overlooking the yard. Help! Pig's got Cuno! Help! Rape! Help! The boy joins in. He's got the Cuno! Help! Just answer the questions. Help! He's digging his, Escalate, Cuno! You're afraid! Pigs are hooting, Cuno! Somebody, please! It's full blast now. The wind carries the message far and wide across Martinez. This looks to be trouble. Logic says, how did we get here? How did this happen? This makes no sense. There may still be a way out. Just appeal to his reason. Shut him down? Be logical, kid. I haven't done anything to you. Logical, he snorts. Help! The logical pig is fiddling Cuno. Are you high right now? Help, mistress, help! He prances around, eyes bulging out of their sockets, rolling hard, yelling at the windows. He's flashing Cuno. He's showing his genitals. If you don't help Cuno now, it will be too late. Hopefully no one's watching. Shut him down with the physical instrument. Which was my glove. Success. Thump. The blow connects surprisingly well, leaving your knuckles tingling. I'm not good at the physical stuff, you know. The disoriented 12-year-old is trying to get his bearings. I think we can have a normal conversation now. Am I right, Cuno? Kim says, Officer, this is very far from normal police conduct. The lieutenant breaks his silence. Get yourself together. For heaven's sake, he thinks, this has gone too far. Don't make it this any worse than it is. Just get back to questioning the kid. Okay. Okay, pig. He's no longer wearing his demonic grin. Something happened. The punch made him calmer. Cuno knows respect that violent stuff. You should see Cuno's dad. Cuno's dad doesn't give a crap about anything, he declares with pride. The creature behind the fence has fallen ominously silent. Only her eyes are alive, jumping from actor to actor. Okay, pig, talk to Cuno. We're back in this crap. He brushes the dirt off his pants. The hell do you want? This is very low. The body. What do you know about it? Crap load, pig. What's your question? Cuno S. says, don't tell the pig anything, Cuno. Kim, help me out here. What do we want to know? If I were to want to waste my time, which I do not, I would ask them who he is, how he got there, and the usual. The usual being, have you seen anything out of the ordinary? Have you seen anything suspicious? Do you know who he was? Cuno's gimp. He picks up a rock. Cuno uses the gimp for target practice. He's trying to hide the fact that he doesn't know. So you don't know anything. Cuno knows all kinds of crap. Cuno's not a snitch, that's all. He shakes his head, clearly offended. Trying to make the Cuno sing into the papaphone. Papaphone. Do you know how it got up there? Probably client. Cuno was busy down the road when that crap went down, so you didn't see it happening. You heard Cuno. Cuno wasn't even in Martinez. Cuno wasn't in Revachol. He puffs himself up. Cuno wasn't regional. Oh, okay. Where did you go then? I don't know. He looks around, trying to come up with something. Mesk, or I don't know. Some other place. Night City. Cuno was in Night City. There is no Night City anywhere. That sounds like the name of a city in some pulp science fiction novel. That's a fictional city name. Night City doesn't exist. Why you gotta be riding Cuno's ass? You haven't been where Cuno's been. You haven't been in Cuno's head. Thank God for that. Bad enough in my own head. You want to know what Cuno was? You want to know what Cuno's been up to? Don't tell him that, Cuno. It's lame. It's not lame. Cuno's building Cuno's city. Night City, Rage City, the City of Rage. That's it. And it's not lame. Lame. That's the name of Cuno's city. Get the hell off Cuno's back. This isn't about that. It's impossible to deduce what it is about, at least for the moment. If it's important, it'll come up later. Focus on the case. Have you seen anyone suspicious around? Just a couple of pigs sniffing around in the dirt. That seems pretty suspicious to Cuno. Yeah, you tell the Fagari, Cuno. Okay, Redrick says, look like you're a Fagari now, whatever that means. The suspicious question doesn't really work in antagonistic situations. More on this later. Right now, let's talk about something else. You're testing Kuno's patience here. Get lost. About the crime scene, you kids often play in this yard? Right, Pig, this is where Cuno plays with his little wooden choo-choo. How you want with it? I might have questions later, but for now let's talk about something else. Yeah, whatever. Cuno doesn't give a crap. Spits over his shoulder and then looks back up at you. I'm off. Cuno doesn't care. Whatever. Smells like spoiled meat and curdled dairy. A human being decomposes. This kid's ladder is rickety but still climbable. Someone is trying to grow herbs in this greenhouse. What's this down here? Perception. There are several footprints in the mud left by work boots. Anywhere from 6 to 12 pairs have walked here. Let's try this visual calculus, get an exact count.